Hi, I'm Shirley. I'm the creator at Bark Art, and I use bark from my local environment to make geometric patterns and people, dogs, animals, anything. My inspiration comes from the different colours that I see, and often I won't know till I'm out collecting the bark and there may be a piece that I pick up and then it just inspires me. I always wait to see, I look out the back door and I can see the trees in the main street waving in the wind, and when it's like that I know there's going to be a lot of bark on the ground. So that's a day to take a bag out, go and have a really good look and pick up some wonderful colours and some wonderful pieces that have fallen on the ground. And people will be looking and thinking, what's that lady doing over there? Perhaps we should be calling somebody to take her away. Paper bark ones seem to come up really well, because with paper bark you can get a number of different layers, and what you can do is you can actually peel a little bit at a time and peel and peel and peel, and you can get down to a colour that you really like or that gives it a special tone. Those colours can make different things. So you'd go the creamy colours for the legs, and the whitey colour might be a dress, and the darker colours might be a hat. I was involved in a very traumatic accident and had bad damage to my leg and my hand. And now, to keep my hand going, I need to be able to use some fine motor skills, which is picking up small things and just using it like writing and that. And I've found that this has been a wonderful rehab to help me along with keeping my hand and my physical skills going and helping me with arthritis, which is now setting in. So it's been a wonderful tool for me to keep that going. Having found the bark art, it has really transformed me, because I'm now broadening my horizons. I'm going out to markets, I'm meeting wonderful people, and I'm getting wonderful feedback and comments from the work that I've done, and people appreciate the work. However, they don't know the trauma that's behind it all, and since that time, it has changed the way I look at the world and the way I deal with things. I've just found out that my hand is not getting any better, and I'm to have further surgery on my hand in January next year. And with that, there'll be, you know, a time off from doing my craft, but that won't stop me from doing what I love now. So I'll find a way, whether it's using my other hand or my mouth, using something, or even my feet if I have to. I'm now getting to the stage that I'm looking at selling online, because that would be really beneficial to me as I'm getting older, as you can see, and it will be an avenue for me to continue my hobby and something that I really enjoy. Should you like my work, that's fantastic. Come and see me at my markets. I advertise each week as to where I'll be on Facebook and on Instagram, and I'd be more than happy to speak to you if you'd like something on commission, and particularly if you'd like to use your own bark. Yeah, I think it would be wonderful to be able to pass this on to others, because I know how much pleasure I have got out of all creating my pieces, and if somebody else can do that and they get as much pleasure as that, I'd be more than happy.